Hello, I'm Dr. Petrache, diabetologist. Today, at your request, I am talking about bloating after eating. Bloating is the swelling of the abdomen that appears especially after meals due to excessive gas production or due to a problem with the movement of the intestinal muscles. The bloating can cause pain, discomfort, and a feeling of fullness. It can also make your abdomen look more swollen. About 30% of people complain of bloating after dinner. Although bloating is sometimes caused by serious medical conditions, it is most often caused by diet and food or ingredients that you don't tolerate. Here are some natural ways to get rid of bloating after eating. First of all, don't eat too much at once. The feeling of fullness can be confused with bloating, but the real problem is that you simply ate too much. If you usually eat large meals and tend to feel unwell after meals, try to reduce portions, add more meals if necessary. A person with a tendency to bloat will experience discomfort with a smaller amount of food compared to people who do not have this predisposition. That's why, if you start to eat smaller portions, you'll notice the difference. I also recommend that you chew your food better. This way, you will reduce the amount of air you swallow with your food, and also you will eat more slowly. You should not ignore food allergies and intolerances either. When you eat foods that you don't tolerate, your gas production will increase. Among the most common intolerances, I mention lactose intolerance, fructose intolerance, egg intolerance, but also gluten intolerance. The next tip is about the air you swallow with your food. There are two sources of gas in the digestive system. The first source is the bacteria in the gut. The second source is the air we swallow when we eat or drink. When we talk about beverages, carbonated beverages are considered the most harmful. They have carbon dioxide, a gas that can be released from liquid only after it reaches the stomach. Chewing gum, drinking with a straw, eating food in a hurry, but also talking during a meal can lead to swallowing an increased amount of air. It is also not good to eat foods that release large amount of gas through digestion. Some foods high in fiber can lead to increased gas production. Among these foods, I mentioned beans, lentils, but also certain cereals. Try to keep a food diary to understand what type of food tends to bloat you. Fatty foods can slow down the digestion. They may have satiety benefits and possible weight loss, but they can cause problems for people who have a tendency to bloat. Try to eat less dry beans and less fat to see if it helps. Irritable bowel syndrome is the most common digestive disorder in the world. It has no proven causes, and among the common symptoms, I mentioned bloating, abdominal pain, discomfort, diarrhea alternating with constipation. Most patients with irritable bowel syndrome experience bloating. If you have irritable bowel syndrome and you are bloated after meals, it can help if you avoid wheat, onions, garlic, broccoli, cabbage, cauliflower, beans, apples, pears, and watermelon. I know it can be hard to give up these foods especially if they are part of your daily diet, but giving them up can help you a lot. The sixth tip refers to sugars in the form of alcohol that are commonly found in foods marked as sugar-free and chewing gum. These sweeteners are considered safe alternatives to sugar. However, they can cause digestive problems if consumed in large quantities. Bacteria in the large intestine digest it and produce gas. Try to avoid sweeteners such as xylitol, sorbitol, or mannitol. Erythritol may be better tolerated, but it can also cause digestive problems if consumed in large quantities. It is good to avoid constipation, and you can find a video on my channel on how you can naturally get rid of constipation. Constipation is very common and can have different causes. A good and effective way to get rid of constipation is hydration, but also physical activity. The use of probiotics also seems to help. Gases produced by bacteria in the gut are the main cause of bloating. There are many types of bacteria found in the gut, and they can vary from person to person. Several clinical trials have shown that probiotics can help reduce gas production in people with digestive problems. Last but not least, I advise you to go to the doctor to make sure that your bloating is not a symptom of a severe chronic condition. That's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and like the video. I am Dr. Petrache, and until next time, take care of your body and soul.